that sugar is bad for you. Okay? Yet almost every food you might purchase at any store mm-hmm. has sugar in it, right? So if you stop and think about that, they say violence is bad for you. Yet every show on TV has violence. So if you stop and think about that, then you know you start to step back from it and you begin to open up and your thoughts start to change a bit.
Yeah, I understand.
Awareness comes.
Well, see, that's part of the challenge because stepping away from it is the greatest challenge because people are constantly busy being busy all in it.
And part of it is the hustle for money. And I realize that. And I realize that.
Well, see, that's part of the problem, you know, because, you know, that's part of the big
care,
incentive
sure.
motivation. And that's why even if I must bring up the guy, Malcolm X, when he was uttering the words that, you know, the price of freedom is death. And we don't mean that literally, meaning that you have to, you know, stop doing something so and cut it off, right? So it's like, okay, great, the food chain or whatever have you, a lot of stuff is not good for me. Okay, great, stop eating for a while. Or, you know,
or eat something different.
Or eat something different. Or do something. You know, just have to stop doing
right.
it. You have to cut it off, right?
Cut it off.
And that takes a sacrifice to do that. But, you know, because of the idea of lust, and we can even have a whole subject on that, because lust comes in so many different packages. You know, most people only relate it to, like, you know, sexual matters, right? But, you know, people's lust for their television shows. The addictions. That's correct. And so being able to manage that, mm-hmm. right, and not adhere to it, even though you know it's kind of tugging your strings a little bit, right?
It's hard. It's hard, no. but it can be
but
done.
But it can be
it
done.
It can be done.
Absolutely.
And the payoff is so phenomenal.
But what are the basic steps, Norma? Where do I start to begin to get away from all the stuff that I'm being fed so that I can move on, you know, and let my road be traveled successfully without all of this?
First,
what do
stop
I do?
And take a deep breath.
Okay.
Take a deep, just breathe. As Ayanda Van Zandt says, breathe. Take a deep breath and relax. Begin to meditate. Begin to go inside and listen. Because, you know, the voice of the universe, the voice of God speaks to us all the time. But we move so fast that we don't hear it. So if you slow down enough, you hear the voice and you have your direction. You're told what to do. I mean, everyone's path is different.
I know. That's very interesting, too, because I was reading your information. You were talking about this ear infection that you had. Right?
Oh, yeah.
And it's amazing. You know, the whole idea of the labyrinth is, of course, an inner working of the ear, right?
Yes.
And then, you know, as it says biblically, faith cometh by hearing, right? And as I've heard that over and over again, I said, why aren't people really learning more and more about the ears if then faith cometh by hearing, right? I mean, you've got your semicircular canals and vestibules, and they're all, you know, they kind of form.
The labyrinth work, too, with the labyrinth spiritual walk.
Right, exactly.
So, which is also taking you inner and helping you to meditate and slow down
right,
and
exactly.
hear and listen.
But yes, so with that in mind, after I understood that, you know, I went and got me a book on anatomy, and I started studying all of the inner workings of the ear, because I understood if I wanted to continue to build upon my faith, that means my hearing capabilities had to continue to increase on a day-by-day basis, too. And also, this is what helps you annihilate fear, you guys, when you're developing that faith, the evidence of things not seen and the substance of things hoped for. That's correct.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes, that's was very, very intriguing, but it also shows how... Still, some things that, you know, kind of give us anxiety, you know, for a period of time can be a signal to a potential talent and gift that we possess.
If you slow down and listen.
Yeah.
Exciting.
Yeah, yeah.
Very, very true. And as we are winding up here, Norma, did you have any closing notes for our audience? You've been just totally brilliant and magnificent.
Well, you've made it very easy and a pleasure to be here. So I guess my thoughts to people would be just to slow down. Take a break. You know, the life's going to go on with or without us. You know, our lives are going to end at some point. So why not have a life that's a life of value and meaning? Why not have a life that's directed to the purpose that God sent you here for? Slow down and listen.
Absolutely. Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to thank you for appearing on another segment of Let's Talk Success. We trust that these ideas were thought-provoking and added to your insight to help you achieve more of the things that you want out of life. On behalf of SMI, Success Motivation Intelligence, and we're the giants in the field of human growth and development, this has been another segment of Let's Talk Success. Conversation that just makes sense. And if I may leave you with this, my colleague and constituent, Mr. Paul J. Meyer, and he said, whatever you vividly imagine, ardently desire, sincerely believe, and enthusiastically act upon must inevitably come to pass. And from yours truly, Mr. LaSalle, HDC, the resurgence of Camelot, I call this the $1 zillion inscription. And there is no greater reward in life than the commitment to the development of your full potential as a human being to become a super being. Thank you very much.